الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. أهل السنة والجماعة، أهل حديث، أهل أثر، the Salaf al-Saleh, the Salafiyun of this time, they trace their origin back to the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's who preceded them. Our creed, our manners, the way we interact as a society, the laws, the regulations, all of it comes from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We trace our origin back to Ahl al-Haq. And the beginning of the people of the truth starts with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And a beautiful statement of one of our Salaf, Abu Mudhaffir Sam'ani. And he was a 5th century scholar. He died in 489 Hijri. He said a beautiful thing in regards to the way the people of Hadith, the way they trace their origins back to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Unlike Ahl al-Bidah, for example, if you have the people of today, those extremists who blow themselves up and do this and make regard other Muslims as being disbelievers, those people trace their roots to who? They trace their roots back to the Khawarij and the Shia. They trace their roots back to Abdullah ibn Saba and all these other groups, even the Ash'aris, who change the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They distort the meanings. Who do they trace their roots back to? To Imam Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, rahimahullah ta'ala, who changed his aqidah, and there's ample evidence from his books and from the books of those who reported on him to show that on the end of his life he repented from that creed. But the Ash'aris still hold on to that and still distort the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But let's see how Ahl al-Hadith, how Ahl al-Sunnah traces their roots back to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How the Salafiyun, how they are those people in this day and age who tamassak بهذا السنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال أبو مظافر السمعاني رحمه الله تعالى في انتصار أهل حديث. This is in his book. It's called انتصار لأهل حديث. This is on page 44. He said, أبى الله أن يكون الحق والعقيدة الصحيحة إلا مع أهل الحديث. He said that it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited that the truth and the correct aqidah would be except with the people of the hadith. لأنهم أخذوا دينهم وأقاعدهم خلفا عن السلف وقرنا عن قرن بإسناد متصل إلى أن انتهى إلى تابعين وأخذ تابعون من أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا طريق إلى المعرفة ما دعا إليه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الناس من الدين المستقيم وصراط القويم إلا هذا الطريق الذي سلكه أصحاب الحديث. In this beautiful statement, and it shows you how the early scholars highlighted this point, and this is a 5th century scholar. He said that Allah has prohibited that the truth and the correct creed would be except with the people of Hadith. And this is because they took their religion and their creed, the people, the later generations, from the early generations, generation after generation, with a sound chain of narration. Until that chain went all the way to the tabi'een. The tabi'een meaning the people who took their knowledge from the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who met Sahaba as Muslims and died as Muslims, and they benefited and they were on the correct creed of Ahl al-Sunnah. So they took they traced their chain of narration back to the tabi'een, who took their religion from the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there is no other path to know and understand what the Prophet, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, called to accept the straight deen, the straight religion, the straight path, except by the same path that the people of Hadith have traversed. So this shows us that the path to the truth and the correct aqidah comes from the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What they were upon, how they understood the names and attributes of Allah. Did they distort the names? Did they negate the names? Did they try to talk about how the names and attributes were? No. They stopped with the Nusus. Did they make takfir of the people because of their major sins? Did they speak about the leaders and make takfir of them and make kharuj on them? No. They stopped with the Nusus. They stopped where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered them to stop. Sallallahu alaihi wa alaihi wasallam. And radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'een. And this is the tariq and sabil al-mu'mineen. This is the straight path. And this is how our salaf, those people who preceded the salaf as-salih, the pious predecessors, this is the path that they left us upon. So if you want to know in this day and age how to follow the truth, how to follow the correct aqidah, then you have to adhere to what those early generations were upon, and those after them, and those after them, all the way up until this time. Ahl al-haq mawjood. The scholars are here to make clear for us the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that only comes with the scholars of Ahl Sunnah. That only comes with the scholars of the Salaf as-Salih. That only comes from the scholars, the Salafi scholars, those people who adhere to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the understanding of the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of our scholars and bless us to follow their guidance and what they have explained for us and made clear for us. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.